Hey, it's Don, the Auction Professor here. Today we're going to talk about another BOLO item. We're going to show you some brochures today, something that I look for everywhere I go. Let's hop over there right now and show you some. So here's just a touch on brochures. Now this is the top of the heap. This is probably the one of the most expensive brochures you could ever find. It's for the White Star Lines Olympic and Titanic. Very scarce. This covered both ships. They were both in the same line. So this is the complete brochure. Extremely scarce. Obviously, after the Titanic sunk, there were no more brochures issued, and all the other ones were pulled and trashed. So any of these are fairly scarce. So this is the primo top of the pack of what you would want to find. Obviously, most people will never find this. This is probably the only one I've ever seen up complete like this on eBay. There's been parts and pieces, and we'll show you a few in a few moments here, but awesome example of an early brochure worth a lot of money. Now the next one here is just for a 707 airliner, Boeing 707. 707s still fly. I have been in a 707 in my life, many 727s on and up, but it's an older plane from 1961. This still went for $643. All of these early ones for airplanes go, especially the ones that are for commercial jets. Not as many of those would be made as like a small business style jet or like a Lear or something along that line. Now here we go with a Ferrari one. Any of these sports car brochures go for a ton of money, especially if it's a vintage original. This is for the spider version of it. Now we're just showing you the Ferrari one here, but most of these early sports car ones will sell for some incredibly high amount of money. American cars or not, they all sell. The foreign ones like this or a Lamborghini, though, will sell for a lot more. Real good example here. Next one is a Santa Fe Railroad. It's a deluxe train booklet. It's for the winter season. Picturesque. It's got stops and locations and information on your travels on their line in 1912. $367. 9 bids. Next one here is a Disney one. This is from the pre-opening. This was given out announcing the park. This is from Walt Disney World, not Disneyland. This is the Florida park. This came out in 1971. These will still be found occasionally. This is probably one of the most expensive ones from pre-opening from Florida that you can find. Now, there's other ones that are worth more money. And this is for Walt Disney World and not Disneyland. Two different parks. Always keep that in mind. 63 bids on this one. $320. Now the next one here is another one of the White Star Lines. Now this is just the cover. Nothing else. And not only that, the actual name, the Titanic, is actually damaged where you can't see the whole name. It still went for $332. Now on the inside, one side is the Olympic and one side is the Titanic. That's the two ships. They're sister ships. It's from the same line, the same time frame, same everything. So again, all rare. This was only around for a very short time because obviously the Titanic sunk on its maiden voyage, so it didn't have another chance to go around. So again, key item. Cover, pieces, parts, even a page from this book will still sell and get you some money. Next one here is a John Deere tractor. Just like anything else, tractor stuff always goes for good money. John Deere is at the top of the pack in this type of material. A John Deere brochure like this will sell higher than almost any of the other ones that you can probably find. John Deere, the older they are, the better, of course, as well, too. So the earlier ones, turn of the century or around them, sell for the most. Now the next one is tied to the railroads here. This is for the Liberty Limited. It's a specific train, so there weren't a lot of these. It wasn't like just a timetable or something like that. Pennsylvania Railroad, nice example, good condition, 1920s, $300. It's got a layout of the train itself, some images. It's a rather nice one here. I would definitely say 1920-ish at the newest, I would imagine. By the looks, the color, the whole works. Next one's Johnson Outboard Motors. Outboard motors for boats are extremely popular. People collect those. They collect the advertisement. This is just a single sheet of paper, basically, that folds into the tri-fold like a brochure, and it went for $257. Mostly brochures I get for almost nothing. I can get them in big, huge bulk lots. Sometimes I can get 1,000 brochures for just a few hundred bucks. And I'm talking some good ones too, because most people don't want to sit there and try and figure out which ones are worth it. They don't know how to tell. They don't know how to tell the ages. They don't want to mess with that many individual ones. So in many times I can get big bulk lots of these types of material. And the next item is for a Ford Model A from 1928, $239. They made millions of these. So again, it depends on what the brochure is. One thing too about brochures and all the vintage items that I sell is that they sell all year round. There is no big summer drop-off like in many other categories. If you're selling clothing or necessities or books or electronics, those are seasonal or even related to holidays and things like that. So you just don't sell as many of them in the summer. But collectors collect, so I sell collectibles all year round. My best month ever was last month. This month is just as good as last month, so sales are still not dropping. We are going up. Of course, we're cross-listing. We're doing all this other stuff, so I have no issues whatsoever with sales right now. But I sell this sort of stuff. Keep in mind, it depends on what you sell. Clothing dies in the summer. Books die in the summer. Some of the electronics and games die off in the summer, too, because most people aren't playing as many of them. Vintage people collect. They don't stop collecting because of any time of weather or anything else. They always want to add to their collection. So let's look on the next one here. Next one here is from a hotel in the Adirondack. These early hotel brochures can go for some good money. We had one from Put-in Bay for, I think it was the Hotel Victoria. And I got like $400 for that one. It's not the most I got for a brochure, but it was well up in the top, say, 20. Brochures can go for some mad money, and again, I don't pay much for them. Even if I'm buying them individually, I usually only spend $2 or $3 at the most, even for a top-notch, real nice one. Most people don't think much of them. I can buy them in bulk, as I said, also. Let's look at the next one here. Lamborghini, as I said, $300 for this one. Most any Lamborghini one's going to go for a few hundred bucks. It's just what I find in looking through these for all these years. All of the Lamborghini and sports cars like this always seem to sell for some incredibly high money. School ones. Some of the colleges and school brochures sell for a lot of money too. This is one that actually had a modernist photography class, and they actually are addressing it here as well too. You can see them all set up taking some photographs. Nice one here. It's the subject matter that sells most of these type, and the school involved in general. So $300 on this one. You just can't knock some of these. These are quick sales probably too on something like this. They did it as a bin. No best offer. It just sold straight out. Next one here is from California. Just like postcards and collectibles in general, California items are hot, even in brochures. So California items I always look for, whatever they are. Brochures, awesome for California-wise. Early 20s, it's an area you just don't find stuff from very often. It's from the 20s. It's from an area you don't find many items from. These, the condition is everything. They have to be in real nice condition to garner the top dollar on these. So again, condition, condition, condition on these. Age in California really adds to a bunch of these. The older they are in most brochures, the more they will be worth. Next one here is a 1931 Eastern Air Transport one. Now, the earlier on these air ones, the better. There's not many of these floating around anymore. Had this been newer, it wouldn't have been worth anywhere near this kind of money. Almost $200, 27 bids on this one. Now, the next one here is an Enchanted Tiki Room brochure from Disneyland. Anything from the Enchanted Tiki Room sells for a ton of money. There's even LP records with music from the Enchanted Tiki Room. Postcards, anything from the Enchanted Tiki Room seems to sell incredibly high. This is a great example. There's an earlier version of this one that even goes for more. $177, 37 bids on this one here. Key item for Disney collectors. Everybody wants anything they can find from the Enchanted Tiki Room. I do not believe it exists anymore. I could be wrong, but I don't think it's there anymore. Now the next one's a Hawaiian Islands brochure. Royal Hawaiian Hotel. It's one of the most popular hotels from that area. It's one of the ones you'll find the most of. They promote it a lot. They were huge. It was right there on the beach. Well-promoted hotel. So you will find some of these. $170 basically. Nice images on there as well. Really nice one in all honesty. The Territory of Hawaii would help sell this as well too, putting that in the title. Now the next one here is Lake Tahoe. As I've said, anything Lake Tahoe goes for some good money. This one's from the Fallen Leaf Lodge. Now, if you had a postcard from the same place, it's going to go for a ton of money. More so than this, because especially if it's a real photo postcard or real picture postcard. This one went for $160. Real nice one here, honestly. And the last one here is just a Michigan ski lodge brochure. Now, this is fairly scarce. There's not a lot of ski lodges in Michigan that I'm aware of anymore. This one went for $152. Rule of thumb on these, if they're early and they're from the 50s or before, I will take a chance for a quarter or something. I will definitely look them up if they're more than that. Spend your time. Some of these look like other ones, and you may be off by a few years on date, so date is key on some of these as well. The first ones ever printed from a place are usually the best ones you can get, especially like Disneyland. There are sites online, too, that you can actually source and look up years and printage and things like that on Disneyland material as well. But that's what I have for you today. Well, there you are. There's some other items that we look for. Hopefully that gave you some ideas and some thoughts. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that like button down below. You can also hit the bell icon to be notified if I post new content or go live. Subscribe and tell a friend.